Hi, my name is Mariana, and this is my friend Ethan. I'm a senior in planetary science at Purdue.
And I'm a junior in physics and astronomy here at Purdue.
So you're probably wondering why we have all these boxes here. We're going to use these to create a planetary surface. In the next decade, we're going to be sending with NASA a lot of missions to faraway moons and asteroids and planets. And so these orbiters need to be able to map the surface of these terrains in order to land a rover safely. So we're going to use these boxes to create our planetary terrain. And these boxes are going to represent boulders and rocks and volcanoes and other things on the surface of your planet. In real space exploration missions, scientists use radar or microwaves to map the terrain of a planet. In this experiment, we're going to be using sonar or sound waves to do that. And we'll be using this sonar device, which we will move over the boxes and it will give us a measurement of both the position and the time. So let's show you what that looks like. Here we have the Vernier motion detector, which is attached to a meter stick, allowing us to get good access to the planetary surface. And then we have a string, which is attached to a weight, which is for our trial 1 meter, but you can use any distance you want. And so as you're scanning, you'll be using the string, which will be touching the ground, in order for you to keep a constant distance as you're scanning. So let's do a trial run and see what we get. You can notice that as I'm walking, I'm keeping the weight touching the ground, I'm keeping the meter stick level, and I'm trying to walk at a constant pace. So here we have a graph of the data we collected. And so to analyze this, we can get a reference bar by clicking on the screen. And so when interpreting this, up to about 5 seconds here, this is just noise just from getting the sensor into position. So this data we can ignore here. But when we go over to 5 seconds, we can see data all the way at 1 meter, which is where our sensor was. And then here at this location, we've reached the first feature in our terrain. We can see that this is at about 0.7 meters from the sensor. And then as we continue traveling across, the distance increases up to a smaller feature. And this continues until we can see that the distance increases back to 1 meter, meaning that there is no feature at this location here. And we wanted to calculate how high this feature is. We would have to subtract the 0.7 meter value from the baseline of about 1 meter that we collected at the beginning. And if we wanted to calculate the length of this feature, we would have to know the time across this feature, which we can calculate by looking with the reference bar, and also the pace at which we walked. Here you can see an example of a terrain some students made, and you can see how this student is keeping the sensor level with the ground and the string with the weight at an equal distance. Students will incrementally repeat passes across the whole surface of their model terrain until they have scanned the entire area, and then upload their data to Excel to create their 3D model representation. So here you can see some student data graphed on Excel. And so here we can see the flat surface and a few boxes that the students were able to scan. But this doesn't give us a really good representation of what their surface looked like. So we can change a few things. So in format plot area and in the 3D rotation section, we're gonna go to depth and change it to the maximum of 2000. And so this gives us a more realistic view of what their planetary surface looked like. And then you can change the XY rotation to get a better perspective. This fun experiment provides students with opportunities to use their imagination and creativity in both designing their planetary surface as well as planning and executing ways in which to collect their data. It also models one way in which planetary scientists learn about surface features of distant objects through remote sensing. In the description of this video, you will find the complete written lesson and teacher guide for this experiment in the list of sensors and other materials you'll need. We hope you had fun doing yet another experiment from Saturday Morning Astrophysics at Purdue. I'm Mariana. See you next time.